Welcome to Grilling with Spice. My name is Cheyenne Ledyard. I'm your host and pit master here in Charleston, South Carolina at The Den. Today's segment is called Under the Dome, and it will be your professional guide at grilling and smoking on your grill dome. On the grill dome today, we have bacon pops. But before we get to those bacon pops, we're going to take a word from our sponsor. So sit back, relax, and when we get back, it's time to barbecue.
Welcome to thebarbecuepantry.us. We are your barbecue headquarters. From sauces to rubs to barbecue kits, we have what you need to take your barbecue from good to great. We also specialize in gift kits and gift baskets. So this holiday season, remember the barbecue pantry. Thebarbecuepantry.us, where it's always time to barbecue.
Now, welcome back. I said today we're going to have bacon pops, and they are awesome. They're salty and they're sweet and they're full of bacon love. So let me show you what we've got here. Here are bacon pops. Are you guys ready to make these? Because I am. So let's get to the grill dome and start to grill.
Okay, so here we have the grill dome lit, and we're going to set the grill dome up for the bacon pops today. The first thing you want to do is you want to put in the indirect rack, like so. So I'm going to put that in there. So the bacon pops are going to sweat a lot of bacon grease. We're going to not want that to burn. So we're going to put the pizza stone for indirect grilling. Make sure that's nice and level, because the next thing you're going to add is going to be a half sheet pan or pie tin, something of that nature, that you can put the bacon pops over so that the bacon grease does not drip into your coals. The next thing you want to do is add on your regular grill grate. And we've got the grill dome set up for bacon pops. So we'll let this get to temperature and I'll show you exactly how to make those bacon pops.
All right, welcome back to Grilling with Spice. Today we've got the bacon pops, and I've got a nice center cut slice of bacon here. Now I've had my butcher slice it into about an eighth of an inch thick. You'll find this in the grocery store as the thick sliced bacon. Take that bacon with the most tapered end towards you, fold it over, not quite to the top, about a half inch to an inch from the top, and then start your roll. Now, when you're rolling, make sure that you're keeping the fat side of the bacon the most even. That's going to do two things when you're done rolling. One, it's going to make sure you have a nice flat surface, so when this bacon pop is grilling, it doesn't topple over. And two, it's going to give you a nice uniform presentation, as you see there. So I'll show you that one more time. Take the most tapered end, folding it almost all the way to the top, about a half inch to an inch away. Then, when you're rolling, making sure that you keep the fat edge as even as possible. Once that's done, it gives you a nice, even bottom for grilling and a nice, clean appearance for the bacon pops. So I'm gonna finish rolling this stack of bacon, and when we get back, we're gonna put these on the grill and it's time to barbecue. So as you can see, I have the grill dome set to around 400 degrees. That's perfect for the bacon pops and to render the fat and make them nice and crispy. So now all we've gotta do is add the bacon pops to the grill dome. So now all you need to do is, when you're adding the bacon pops to the grill dome, is remember to keep the bacon over your foil pan here, so none of the fat drips down into your coals and creates any unwanted flare-ups and or burnt smoky taste when the actual bacon grease is to burn on the coals. So I'm gonna add these like so, in nice even rows. If you have one fall over, you can also use the toothpicks to kind of sturdy them. But if you've done your job at the beginning and made sure that that fat cap of the bacon was nice and even, you shouldn't have any problem with them falling over. Except for the occasional one that wants to be a pain. And that's always going to happen. You're always going to have one. We'll be right back.
Mustang Sally. All right, so here we are on grill cam, and as you can see, we've got the grill dome popping, looking great. Oh man, look at those. Those are looking spectacular. They're just now starting to get nice and crispy. They've been in about 30 minutes now. And we're gonna let that fat render just a little bit longer. So, I'm gonna close this grill dome lid, and when we get back, I'm gonna show you how to put the Candy Q barbecue sauce from Lead Yard Barbecue Company on these babies. Okay, so it's been about an hour. Bacon pops are looking nice and crisp. They're looking great. We've got a few that have fallen over, but that's okay because they've stayed over the tin. The oil has stayed into the tin and there was no flare-ups. I like them nice and crispy, and all you need to do now is remove them from your grill dome. Okay, so now it's time to finish off the bacon pops. I've pulled them off of the grill dome and they've grilled to perfection. What you want to do is you want to take a lollipop stick, take the bacon pop, take out the toothpick, and in the same hole the toothpick was inserted in, insert your lollipop stick, like so. Then, just set onto a plate. Today we'll be using the world famous Lead Yard Barbecue Candy Q Hickory Glaze. This stuff is awesome. I like it because it's nice and sweet and it marries well with the bacon pops. The saltiness of the bacon, the sweetness of the sauce is just awesome. So I'm just going to drizzle this on like so to the bacon pops.